चारिणे निर्वितश्या शून्यवारी पश्चात्यानिशतारिणे
Yeah.
Krishna Krishna Hari 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 Rama Hari Rama 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 Hari Hari
Hare Krishna
Can you copy it? Can we use one of these Wi-Fi?
Oh, you have one? This one has Type-C in there. I can bring my Type-C.
Yeah, that's what I'm asking you.
Oh, you want that one? Hub. Hub is in there.
He's bringing what?
The connector. He has a connector.
Really? Okay.
But in the meantime, let me also try to put it.
Okay. It was cold when I first came in here, now it's become hot.
Email password,
I wouldn't know. Mm-hmm.
You have to email this to me.
Huh?
Email this. Okay, he has it written for
me. Say hello. What did you do?
Just open it and put it back
again. Okay. Thank you. Okay, Hare Krishna, welcome everyone this morning to this first lesson, first class we're giving here during this 3-day, 4-day convention.
Hare Krishna, 首先欢迎大家来到这里参加我们三天大会第一天的第一堂课。
And there's a lot of other speakers but also giving classes at the same time.Quite a few people wanted Tamil seminars, so there's some very nice Tamil speakers who have come from India to give classes.
有不少人想聆听泰米尔语的讲课，所以呢，有一些从泰米尔来的嘉宾，他们在用泰米尔语讲课。
So we wanted to talk here about.Bhakti Yoga, which is our real mission in becoming devotees.
在这里我们想讨论一下 Bhakti Yoga, 也就成为真正的奉献者，这个是我们的使命。
So one of the important points we want to understand is, what is pure devotional service?
我们想理解的一个重点就是到底什么是纯粹的奉献服务？
Because often people come to Krishna consciousness with many different ideas.
因为人们经常在进入 Krishna 知觉的时候会有不同的想法。
And we heard this morning during Bhanu Swami's class how people can understand the absolute truth in many different ways.
今天早上我们从巴布马哈拉的课中听到有不同的人他们可以用不同的方式来理解绝对真理。
He was mentioning that important verse from the 10th canto where Krishna comes into the wrestling arena in Mathura.
他谈到在芝麻巴格坦第十篇中一个重要的诗节提到 Krishna 来到了 Mathura 的摔跤场。
And different people all saw Krishna in different ways.
有不同的人用不同的方式看待 Krishna.
Kamsa had brought Krishna and Balaram there to Mathura and arranged the wrestling match.
Kamsa 把 Krishna 和 Balaram 带到了 Mathura, 他做出了一个安排要进行摔跤比赛。
And so many.Other people, all the people of Mathura also came to see. And the people had some devotees, Nanda Maharaj, the cowherd boys, they'd all come from Vrindavan. And so they'd all come to see this wrestling match.You know, it was a big event in Mathura.
这是 Mathura 的一个大世界。
And it was in the special arena. There was a special stadium which was there. The wrestling match was to take place inside the stadium.
在这个特殊的摔跤场之内有个很大的体育场。这个摔跤比赛就将在体育场之内进行。
So.Bhanu Swami was listing all the different moods of the different people there. Kamsa, he saw Krishna as death personified. And the wrestlers.Who were going to fight with Krishna, but they saw Krishna like a thunderbolt. But the ladies of Mathura, they saw Krishna as the most wonderful Cupid. And the cowherd boys, they saw Krishna as their friend. So all the 12 different rasas, there are 12 rasas which the people can have with Krishna. Of course, five are direct, they're the devotee rasa.
当然了，五种是直接的，是奉献者的rasa。
But there are seven which are indirect.
但是还有七种是间接的。And
some different times, different moods and are exchanged between Krishna and these different people.
而且在不同的时间，Krishna跟不同的这些人们之间的情感会改变。So
this science of pure devotional service. This was instructed by Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to Rupa Goswami. You can see in the illustration here that's Rupa Goswami. He was already older man when he gave up working for the Muslim ruler. He was working over in a place called Ramakeli. It's a wonderful place. Many cows and a very peaceful, beautiful green place, many trees.
又有很多乳牛，非常的美丽，非常平和的地方，有很多的树木。Rupa
and his brother Sanatan were living there, and they were recreating Vrindavan there.
Rupa 还有他的哥哥 Sanatan 就住在那里，他们在那里重新建造了一个Vrindavan。But
they were in the unfortunate position that they were serving the Mohammedan ruler.
因为他们在服务这个穆罕默德的统治者,
working for people who kill cows, who eat the cow meat.
为杀牛吃牛肉的人而工作。
So Rupa and Sanatan heard about Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
因此 Rupa Goswami 从主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 那里聆听。
And they wrote to him, and Lord Chaitanya came to visit them.
有人给他写信说主 Chaitanya 要来访问他们。
And after Lord Chaitanya came to visit them, they decided they would give up everything and go to join Lord Chaitanya. So Rupa Goswami left home first. Sanatan, somehow he had some entanglements, he could not leave immediately. But Rupa Goswami, he left home and he gave away all, he arranged his money, he gave half of his wealth to the Vaishnavas and the Brahmanas. And he gave 25% for his family. And he kept some 25% for emergencies which he may have. So Rupa Goswami, he had a lot of wealth. It said his wealth was so great it could fill a boat. So when he gave 25% for his family, it was a lot of money for them. They were well taken care of. So Rupa Goswami left the home and he went to find Lord Chaitanya. He heard that Lord Chaitanya was at Prayag. Prayag means the place where the Ganga meets the Yamuna. And Lord Chaitanya was there at Das Ashwamedha Ghat, a place called Das Ashwamedha Ghat. He was staying, he met Rupa Goswami there.
在一个叫做 Dasashvamedha Ghat 的地方，他就在那里见到了 Rupa Goswami。
And Lord Chaitanya instructed Rupa Goswami for 10 days.
主柴坦尼教导了 Rupa Goswami 10天。
And he instructed him in the science of devotional service.
他教导他关于奉献服务的科学。
So.Then Lord Chaitanya told Rupa Goswami, he said, now you go to Vrindavan. And Lord Chaitanya said that Vrindavan is a place for your family. He called it Prabhu Datta Desh, the place given by the Prabhu.
他管这个地方叫 Prabhu Datta Desh， 也就是 Prabhu 给你的地方。
So Rupa went there to Vrindavan. Later on, others came and joined him.
于是 Rupa 去了 Vrindavan， 之后其他的人也到那里去加入他。
There were already some people there in Vrindavan. There were a couple of other Goswamis there.
当时在 Vrindavan 也有其他的人，还有另外的几位 Goswami 也在那里。
But they had not been able to do very much.
但是他们做不了什么事儿。
But Rupa Goswami came there. Later Sanatan came, and then later on their nephew Jiva Goswami came.
后来 Rupa Goswami 去了，再之后 Sanatan Goswami 去了，再之后他们两个人的侄子 Jiva Goswami 也去了。
After Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu disappeared from the world.Then Raghunath Goswami also came to Vrindavan. And in this way they developed Vrindavan. And Lord Chaitanya also personally came to Vrindavan. And he discovered, he showed them where is the Radhakund.And he, in this way, he was establishing the different places of Krishna's pastimes. So Lord Chaitanya told Rupa Goswami and the others, they should also write books about Krishna consciousness.Just like Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada, he wrote books on Krishna consciousness. And he told also his disciples, he wanted them also to write.So Srila Prabhupada also took that instruction seriously. And one of the books which Prabhupada wrote was the book called Nectar of Devotion. And it was based on the book which was written by Rupa Goswami, which was called Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.Rupa Goswami wrote several books.
Rupa Goswami 写了几本书。
But the most famous of his books is this Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.
但是他最著名的书就是这一本 Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.
And in his, he based his book on the teachings he got from Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.Rupa and Sanatan were direct disciples of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Rupa 还有 Sanatan 他们两个人是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的直接的门徒。
Previously, they had most they were called Dabirkas and Sakara Malik. They had Muslim names.So Lord Chaitanya made them Goswamis. One of them, and this is Rupa Goswami. And Rupa Goswami wrote this very important book, the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.
Rupa Goswami 撰写了这本非常重要的书籍，名叫 Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.
When Srila Prabhupada was initiated by Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati Prabhupada, at that time he was told by his Guru Maharaj that you should study carefully Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu.
当 Prabhupada 接受 Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Prabhupada 启迪的时候，他的灵性导师就告诉他，你要认认真真的学习 Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu 这本书。You
have to. He wanted very much that you should study the science of rasa relationships with Krishna.
他特别想让他学习 rasa， 也就是跟 Krishna 的关系的这本书。
So, taking that instruction from his Guru Maharaj, our own Srila Prabhupada began to study very carefully Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. And then when he went to America, he was able to publish the book. So we can chant this nice verse here. This is one of the memorization verses for our Bhakti, is it Bhakti Shastri course?
Yes.
Right, Bhakti Shastri, we like devotees to study the Bhakti Shastri course. And some devotees, they don't like to do it. They say, oh no, no, I don't have time. But it's very important for us to study the books. And Prabhupada liked us to learn the slokas. And when Prabhupada was here every morning, he liked to go for a walk with the devotees. And when we would walk, he would talk, and sometimes he would bring up some philosophy, and he would ask, what is the sloka? I remember even the very beginning of our movement, we did not even have the Bhagavad Gita with the Sanskrit verses. But Prabhupada was still asking, what is the sloka? We didn't even know, we had never seen the slokas. But somehow, sometimes there would be somebody from a Hindu family who knew the sloka, and Prabhupada would say, oh, very good. So Prabhupada was always encouraging us to learn some sloka. And how to learn the slokas? You have to recite them regularly. If every day you recite them, then you start to remember them. Just like every morning we sing the Guru Vastikam, and we sing also Guru Vandana. And you know, of course, when we sing it every day, you start to know it. So these slokas, they are full of spiritual power. If you recite them, they will give you also spiritual energy. And they make it easier to remember Krishna. So you can repeat after me this. Anya bilasita shunyam.
Anya bilasita shunyam.
Jnana karma jnana vritam.
Jnana karma jnana vritam.
Anuku yena krishnano.
Anuku yena krishnano.
Shilanam bhaktirutama.
Shilanam bhaktirutama.
Anya pilasita shunyam.
Anya pilasita shunyam.
Jnana karma jnana vritam.
Jnana karma jnana vritam.
Anuku yena krishnano.
Anuku yena krishnano.
Shilanam bhaktirutama.
Shilanam bhaktirutama.
Anya pilasita shunyam.
Anya pilasita shunyam.
Jnana karma jnana vritam.
Jnana karma jnana vritam.
Anuku yena krishnano. Shilanam bhaktir uttama.
Shilanam bhaktir uttama.
All right, so here is the translation of this verse. When first class devotional service develops, one must be devoid of all material desires. Knowledge obtained by monistic philosophy and fruitive action. The devotee must constantly serve Krishna favorably as Krishna desires. So we have to understand there's devotional service which is not first class. You can read, for example, the third canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, Lord Kapila's teaching to Devahuti, and he describes devotional service in the modes.
大家可以去阅读《诗曼巴格》他们的第三篇，其中主可毗勒的向他的母亲德沃忽提讲述奉献服务，可以出在不同的属性之中。Some
devotional service in the mode of ignorance, devotional service in the mode of passion, and devotional service in goodness are not first class devotional service.
出在愚昧属性之中的奉献服务，出在激情属性之中的奉献服务，以及出在善良属性之中的奉献服务，并不是一流的奉献服务。
What is pure devotional service? Is devotional service which is above the modes of nature.
纯粹的奉献服务到底是什么呢？那就是超越物质自然属性的奉献服务。
So we want to understand what it means to develop pure devotion. So here Rupa Goswami has described, he said, we must be devoid of all material desire. Of course, that's a big thing. We'll think, well, I have so many desires. How can we be without desires? But we have to understand we can purify desires. Our desire, we cannot stop desire, but we can control the quality of our desire. Bhanu Swami was explaining this morning how Srila Vyasadeva wanted people to come from the mode of ignorance, then to the mode of passion, then to the mode of goodness.
Bhanu Swami 今天早晨解释到了如何让人们脱离愚昧的属性，达到激情的属性，然后最后再脱离激情的属性，达到善良的属性。
So here, Rupa Goswami is describing that pure devotional service means to give up all material desires.
在这里，如果狗斯瓦米讲到纯粹的奉献服务，就意味着放弃所有的物质欲望。
And then we have that we can do by just simply changing the quality of our desires.
只要我们能够改变我们的愿望的质量，我们就可以做到这一点。
Instead of just desiring for our own self and for the body, we have to desire for Krishna and Krishna's service.
我们不再为自己的躯体，然后为了自己有愿望，我们是为了 Krishna， 为了服务 Krishna 而有愿望。
And we can do that without even thinking about it. You don't have to get all mental and think, oh no, I cannot give up my desires.
我们其实连想都不用想，也可以达到这样的状态。你不用说太就是运用你的心意，想着我怎么放弃我所有的这些愿望呢？
We just have to engage in Krishna conscious activities.
我们只需要从事 Krishna 知觉的活动就够了。
Just like this morning.We had a morning program.
就像今天早晨，我们做了一个早晨的节目。
We went to the temple. We went to the ballroom, and then the ballroom we had our RT and we sang prayers. And we had some kirtan.
早晨的时候，我们去这个大厅，我们在大厅里面，我们做 RT， 我们一起朗诵世节，然后呢，我们做 kirtan.
We had Tulsi Puja.
我们做了 Tulsi Puja.
We chanted Japa.And then we did Guru Puja, we greeted the deities, we did Guru Puja, and then we heard Srimad Bhagavatam. So we never had time for our material desires. Right? We were chanting, we were doing kirtan, we forgot about everything.
把所有其他的一切都忘了。
We even forgot about what breakfast is going to be.
我们都忘了早餐会是什么了。
We forgot about where we're staying, what room we're in, or who we're with.
我们忘记了自己身在何处，我们住在哪个房间，到底跟谁在一起。
Instead, we are in the big ballroom with 700 people, 800 people.So our desires were changed. So this comes about naturally by doing devotional service. And then also, Rupa Goswami said we have to avoid or give up knowledge obtained by monistic philosophy.So monistic philosophy, this is generally the philosophy of the Mayavadis. The Gyanis, those who practice Gyana Yoga, are often monists. We are dualists, we're not monists.Monists are thinking everything is one. It's all one. And they want to become one, and they want to merge into the oneness. So that kind of knowledge is very contaminating to the consciousness. Why? Because we think, now I'm God.I'm God. You're God, and we're all God. This is their mistaken philosophy. Before I became a devotee, I used to read a lot of these kind of books by the monist philosophers.
在我成为奉献者之前，我就常常阅读这些一元论哲学家们写的书。
Their books are, they're distributed everywhere. You can find everywhere.
他们的书到处都有派发，哪儿都能找到。
They distribute the book. Their philosophy is very common everywhere.
他们把他们的哲学派发的非常普遍。
So when I first went to the temple, they asked me, "Do you know who God is?"
我第一次去庙，他们有人问我，你 吗？
I said, well, yeah, of course. I'm God, you're God, we're all God.
我说当然知道了，你是神，我是神，咱们都是神。
And of course, just like you're laughing, they also laughed at me.
当然了，就像你们在笑一样，他们当时也笑话了我。
And they taught me, of course, I'm not God, but I'm meant to be a servant of God.
他们教会我说，其实我根本不是神，我是神的一个仆人。
So we have to get rid of this false philosophy that everything is one.
所以我们要放弃这种认为所有的一切都是一的错误哲学。
At the same time, there is a oneness of desire.
同时呢，还有愿望的这种合一。
We want to have that unity of desire.
我们想要达到这种愿望的一致性。
We're trying to create unity out of diversity.
我们想在多样性之中创造统一性。
We had a nice program just the day before yesterday in Melaka.
前天我们在马六甲做了一个很好的节目。
One prominent government man came to our center there.
有一个很显要的一个政府官员来到了我们在那个地方的中心。
And he was very favorable to our Krishna consciousness movement.
他对我们的 Krishna 知觉运动非常有好感。
And he was talking, he was explaining to us how the policy in Malaysia is to create unity out of diversity.
他就给我们讲马来西亚的政策是在多样性之中达到统一性。
Because in Malaysia there are different sects of people. You have the Islamic people who are the majority, then you have the Chinese people, and then you have also the Indian people. So there's a lot of diversity in the country.And naturally, the government want to keep the country peaceful.
很显然，很自然的，这个政府就想让国家保持很平和的状态。
And they want to try make sure there is a unity among the people.
所以他们想确保在人们之间有一种统一性。
Most countries they have that kind of policy.
绝大多数国家都有这样的政策。
Like in India, you have also many different groups.Ethnic groups.
就像是在印度也有很多不同的民族。
So, in India, they always that we are all brothers.
在印度，大家都说我们全都是兄弟。
So, on the spiritual platform, there's a oneness, but at the same time, there's a difference.
而在灵性的层面上，既有一，然后也有不同。
So it was Chaitanya Mahaprabhu who gave us the philosophy that there's a oneness, but there's also difference.
就是 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 给了我们这种哲学，就是既有一也有不同。
But the monistic philosophy is that it's just simply one.
但是一元论的哲学呢，讲的就仅仅是一。
And any difference is illusion.
他们说任何的不同都是幻觉。
So that kind of philosophy is not.Not completely correct. So that knowledge has to be given up. And then the third thing which has to be given up is fruitive action. And that's a very common, a very common state of action in devotional service.That we want to get something out of our service to Krishna. So it's devotional service, but it's not first class. So we don't consider that doing service for Krishna with material desires to be pure devotion.
所以我们不认为带着物质愿望去为 Krishna 做奉献服务，这个就是纯粹的奉爱。
We have to look also at our own self and consider our own self. What is our motive in serving Krishna?
我们应该内省，然后应该问问自己，我们服务 Krishna 的动机是什么？
So sometimes, you know, Tamal Krishna Goswami used to ask to me, he said, what do you want from Krishna? What do you want out of devotional service?
Tamal Krishna Goswami 以前常常问我，你想从 Krishna 那要什么？你想从奉献服务之中得到什么？
So at that time I was doing some work. I was cultivating different people. We were doing the life membership program, and we were trying to get people to become life members.
在当时我做的工作就是培养终身会员，试图把别人变成我们的终身会员。
But there was one other devotee. His service was that he was doing a business and he was selling oil paintings.
然后有另外的一个奉献者，他做生意卖油画。
And they were selling a lot of paintings.
他卖很多画。
And he was selling them to devotees all over the world.
而且他卖给全世界的奉献者。
People would come to Hong Kong to buy oil paintings.
人们会来香港买油画。
And devotees would, you know, they were in different parts of the world. They'd take these oil paintings and sell them. It was a kind of Sankirtan. Of course, not really Sankirtan. But the fruit was meant for serving Krishna. So I would say to Tamal Krishna Maharaj, well, I would like to be like him. I would like to have a business and make a lot of money. So that's a very fruitive desire. So we have to give up that kind of mentality. And then Rupa Goswami continues to describe what we should do. He says we have to serve, first of all, constantly. Not in constant service, means all the time we have to be doing service for Krishna. We should go on, you know, all every moment, round the clock. Like we give the example of the convenience store. They have these 7-Eleven stores, you know, they're open all the time. So devotional service should be like that. It should be constant. The more we are on and off, you know, today I'm a devotee, oh, tomorrow I'm tired, you know, I need a rest. Today I'm going out with my old friends, they're not devotees. Tomorrow I'll go with the devotees. We want to be careful. We want to be connected in Krishna consciousness every moment. So Rupa Goswami says we must serve constantly and we must serve Krishna favorably.
Rupa Goswami 说我们必须要不断的去服务，而且我们要顺意的去服务。
As Krishna desires,
就像 Krishna 所愿的那样
not just as we desire,
而不是说如我们所愿的一样
but as Krishna desires,
如 Krishna 所愿的一样
Devotee will do anything for Krishna.
奉献者可以为 Krishna 做任何的事情
Just like sometimes in India, you know, they have a system that there are certain class of people. Their job is to clean the toilets and take the garbage out.
就像在印度有一类人，他们的工作就是清洁厕所，然后呢倒垃圾。
So somebody else may say, "I'm a Brahmana. I'm not going to do that."
然后有的人说，我是一个 Brahmana， 我才不干这样的活呢。
But a devotee will think, what's needed for Krishna's service? I should do whatever Krishna requires. So service to Krishna must be as what Krishna wants. That's difficult to put aside our own ideas. Now in the beginning it's like that, but as you go on and become a stronger devotee, after some time then you can focus more on what is the proper nature, your proper nature. Just like in the beginning of Krishna consciousness movement, some people joined the movement and they were good artists, they were very good artists, but they joined the Krishna consciousness movement, they came to live in the temple and they were told to go on Sankirtan. And they said, well, you know, I'm a musician, I'm an artist, I paint, you know. They said, it's okay, just come on Sankirtan. First they go for Sankirtan, go on Sankirtan and learn also how to distribute Prabhupada's books. And in this way get purification. And then later on, they will get the chance to cultivate more, to do their own activity which is more suited to their nature. If you go to some of our temples, like in Belgium, Radadesh, there's a beautiful temple there, and they have original oil paintings done by the devotees. And similarly, other temples like in Detroit or Los Angeles, there's many original oil paintings that devotees were spending all their time painting. But initially, they were doing Sankirtan. Later on, they became artists. There was one devotee, he was actually born in Russia, but he joined Krishna consciousness in America. So, you know, at one point the devotees started preaching in Russia. So the devotee said, it came to Prabhupada, he said, Prabhupada, you know, I'm Russian, I can speak Russian, should I help and go and help in the preaching in Russia? But Prabhupada told him, he said, you are an artist, you're painting beautiful pictures of Krishna. And your pictures are in our books. He said, by your painting, you're preaching to the whole world. If you go to Russia, you may preach to a few people in Russia. But by your painting, the pictures are preaching to the whole world. So in this way, Prabhupada encouraged him to continue with his painting. Some other devotees were very expert musicians. They would play guitar, or they would, you know, they had some experience playing in a band, playing music.
还有一些奉献者，他们是音乐家，他们可以很好的弹吉他，他们可以在乐队里做一些演出。
And sometimes they would get offers from professional music bands. They would say, "Come and play in our group. Come and join our group."
有的时候他们还会接到邀请，有一些职业的乐队说，哎，请来加入我们的乐队吧。
But the devotees would say, "No, no, I'm singing for Krishna and Balaram."
然后这个奉献者就说，不不不，我要为 Krishna and Balaram 唱歌。
Just like there's one devotee, maybe you know the name Aindra.Aindra Prabhu, he was a famous musician. He left the body some years ago.
就像有一个奉献者，他的名字叫 Aindra. Aindra, 他是一个很著名的音乐家。他已经离开躯体好多年了。
He was from America, and he was living in Vrindavan doing kirtan there.
他原本来自于美国，后来他去了 Vrindavan, 在那个地方做 kirtan.
And in Vrindavan, Prabhupada has the devotees do.24-hour kirtan.
在人大本帕布帕的让奉献者们做二十四小时的 kirtan.
It never stops, summer or winter, day or night. The kirtan is going on all the time.
这个永远不停止，无论是春夏秋冬还是白天黑夜，这 kirtan 一直在进行。
So Aindra Prabhu was leading, and he was organizing this kirtan, getting the devotees to take part.
而 Aindra Prabhu 他就领导着 kirtan 的小组，让奉献者们参与 kirtan。
And he did this service up until he departed from the world.
他做这个服务直到他离开躯体为止。
But he told me, he said, at one point he said some people came from a music band and they asked him, they said, "Why don't you come and join our group? We need somebody like you in our group."
他告诉我说，曾经有人邀请他去参加别的乐队，说。
And they were quite popular group. They were quite successful, quite famous. But he said, "No, no. I said I don't want that. I'm singing for Krishna and Balaram."
他们是非常流行的乐队，是很有名气的。然后呢，很受欢迎。可是 Aindra Prabhu 说不不，我只为 Krishna 和 Balaram 而歌唱。
And similarly also Yamuna Mataji, the lady who sings the Govinda song every morning that we hear, she was also a singer, and she sometimes would sing also in a music group, and people sometimes asked her, "Come and join us again, come and sing for us."
同样道理 Yamuna Mataji, 她就是每天早上搭上的时候唱那个 Govinda 祷文的 Mataji, 她也是一个音乐家，有时候也会有乐队邀请她说你来加入我们，我们需要你这样的人来跟我们一起唱歌。
But she said, "No, no, I'm just want to serve Krishna."
但她就说不不不，我只想服务 Krishna.
I don't want name or fame or money.
我不想要名誉，就是这些名气还有金钱。
So these are some examples about the mood of pure devotee.Okay, so we want to understand the different characteristics which are there in pure devotional service. So there are two kinds of characteristics. One is, first of all, what is called Swarupa Lakshana, or essential characteristics.
首先呢，这个方面叫 Swarupa Lakshana， 也就是首要的特征。
Yeah, it must be there in pure devotional service.
也就是说，在纯粹的奉献服务之中，一定要有的特征。
And the other is called Tathastha Lakshana.
而另外一个方面叫做 Tathastha Lakshana.
And that means marginal characteristics.
这个意思就是边际的特征。
It means sometimes will be there, sometimes not there.
有时候有，有时候没有。
So, two different kinds of characteristics are being described.
所以一共描述了两种不同的特征。
We'll come across this many times in studying the Krishna conscious philosophy.
我们在学习 Krishna 知觉哲学的时候，会经常的遇到这两个概念。
So, Swarupa Lakshana.
Swarupa Lakshana.
And there are three different characteristics which are mentioned.
在这里提到三种不同的特征。
And they're all taken from the definition of pure devotional service.
这些都来自于纯粹奉献服务的定义。
First one is this word anukulyena.
第一个词叫做 anukulyena.
And then Krishna.
然后是 Krishna,
Anushilanam,
最后是 Anushilanam,
Anyabilasitasamyam, Jnana Karma Janavrikam, Anukuyena Krishnanushilanam, Bhaktir Uttamam. So these three words are from the second half of the definition.
所以这三个词来自于这个定义的第二部分。
But these are the essential characteristics.
这些是主要的、首要的特征。
We will explain more in a minute.
我们马上就会更多的解释。
And the tatastha, the marginal characteristics, are mentioned anya bilasita shunyam and jnana karmatyan avritam.We will explain more. Anukulyena, meaning favorable.
Anukulyena 的意思是顺意的。
Mean it must be pleasing to Krishna.
意思是取悦 Krishna.
If you study the Bhagavad Gita.Which I hope you're all doing, then in the 18th chapter, Krishna described to Arjuna, surrender to me.
我希望你们都学习了 Bhagavad Gita, 然后在第七中的十八章里 ,Krishna 谈到 Arjuna 应该臣服于我。
And Prabhupada in the purport then explains what is surrender.
帕帕德在要旨里提到臣服是什么意思。
He explains surrender.Has six different characteristics.
他解释说臣服有六种不同的特征。
Right, the first one is to accept everything favorable to Krishna.
第一项就是接受所有一切有利于 Krishna 的事物。
And the second thing is to give up everything which is not favorable to Krishna.
第二项是放弃所有不利于 Krishna 的事物。
So this is important for us to.Meditate like this, to think, first of all, what is pleasing to Krishna?
我们这样冥想很重要，我们应该首先这样想，到底什么能够取悦 Krishna?
One devotee was making dresses for the deities.
有一个奉献者为神像做衣服。
And she got the idea, she thought, you know, when she was making Krishna's shirt, she thought,I will put a pocket on Krishna's shirt and I'll put sweet balls in his pocket for him.
然后当他给 Krishna 做上衣的时候他就想我要给 Krishna 的衣服都装上兜然后我要为他的兜里装上这个甜球。
Prabhupada told her, this is not how we offer sweets to Krishna.
帕帕德告诉他这不是我们向 Krishna 供奉甜品的方式。
He told her,We make our offerings, we put a plate on the altar in front of Krishna.
帕帕德告诉他说我们是把甜品放在盘子里然后把盘子放在神坛上给 Krishna 供奉。
He told her, don't speculate about how to serve Krishna.
他告诉他说你不要去推测如何去服务 Krishna.
We have to serve Krishna as we are instructed by the authorities.
我们应该按照权威教导我们的方式去服务 Krishna.
Our service to Krishna must be done following the mode of the Acharyas.
我们对 Krishna 的服务的这种方式应该是追随 Acharya 们的情感。
So, how to know what is pleasing to Krishna? We have to hear from people who know Krishna.
我们怎么才能知道怎么去最好的服务 Krishna 呢？我们就需要先去聆听那些已经知道怎么去服务。
The spiritual teachers, the acharyas, they know Krishna and they guide us how we can please Krishna.
灵性的老师还有 acharya 们，他们知道如何去取悦 Krishna， 所以他们可以指导我们。
So first thing is pleasing to Krishna. And the second point is it should be done with the intention to please Krishna. So when we are doing service, that our intention, our purpose, that we want to please Krishna. Because some, you may do something pleasing to Krishna, and you may think, no, I don't like doing this, but anyway, I'm doing it for Krishna, if it pleases Krishna, but it doesn't please me. You may think it's pleasing to Krishna, it doesn't please me. So if we think like that, that is not pure devotion.
有的时候我们去服务Krishna，我们就想着，哎呀，这个事情我根本不想做，也不喜欢做。但是可能Krishna喜欢，那我就先去做吧。但如果你就这样去做的话，你不会取悦Krishna。
Just like if we say to someone, you go on Sankirtan, you go out and chant and do Harinam Sankirtan.
像我们跟一个人说，你出去做Sankirtan，你去唱诵Harinam，然后去做Sankirtan。
No, I don't know why they sent me out on Sankirtan. I don't like to go on Sankirtan.
我不知道他为什么要让我去做Sankirtan，我根本不喜欢去做Sankirtan。
So if we go in that mood, that is not devotion.
如果我们以这种情感去做的话，那就不是奉爱。
We want to please Krishna.
我们想取悦Krishna。
So the attitude in which we perform our service is very important.
所以我们做服务的时候的态度是非常重要的。
That mood must be there, that I want to do this for Krishna's pleasure.
这个情感必须要在，就是我去为了取悦Krishna才做的这个服务。
This is anukulyena.
这就是anukulyena。
It's favorable.
顺意的。
And then we said anukoyena Krishna, it must be in relation to Krishna.
然后我们说 anukoyena Krishna 必须是跟Krishna有关。
So what do we mean when we say Krishna? Who do we mean? Which Krishna? Because Krishna has so many different forms.
当我们说Krishna的时候，我们到底是什么意思？因为我们知道Krishna有很多不同的形象。
So many incarnations.
他有很多的化身。
So when we heard this morning, he's appeared different species of life.
我们今天早上听到他显现在不同的物种之中。
He comes up among the demigods as Lord Vamanadeva.
他作为王曼的出现在半神人之中。
And above and among the humans, he comes as Krishna and Rama.
在人类之中，他显现为Krishna还有Rama.
He comes among the animals as Lord Varaha.
他在动物之中显现为Varaha.
And he comes among the fish as Matsya.
而且他在鱼类之中显现为Matsya.
So he's appearing in so many different forms of life. So what do we, when we say Krishna, what do we mean? So, as Prabhupada explains to us in his introduction to the book, that Krishna means, along with, it means also his personal expansion.
那么正如施洛帕帕德在这本书的导言里边所说的，我们谈到Krishna，这就意味着也包括了他所有的化身，所有的扩展。
And it includes not only such expansions, but also his pure devotees.
而且不仅仅是包括他所有的这些扩展，还有他所有的纯粹奉献者。
So, like Srila Prabhupada, we respect Srila Prabhupada as being one of the representatives of Krishna.
就像Srila Prabhupada，我们尊敬Srila Prabhupada为Krishna的一个代表。
And all the acharyas, we honor their appearance and their disappearances.
还有所有的acharya们，我们去尊敬他们的显现以及隐居日。Because
they are all in relation to Krishna.
因为他们全都跟Krishna有关。And
then?
接下来?
Anushilanam.
Anushilanam.
Anu. Right, just Anuradha.
Anuradha.
So, Anu means to follow or constantly.
Anu 的意思就是追随，而且持续不断的意思。
What's wrong?
Something on the screen, so they are checking it. Now it's okay.
No
All right, so Anu Shilanam constantly means always engaged in that service of Krishna.
Anu Shilanam 就指的是持续不断的，总是从事于对 Krishna 的服务。
And Shilanam, the behavior.
Shilanam 指的是行为举止。
So this is describing the importance of the behavior of the devotee. That it must be proper, it must be according to the proper characteristic of a devotee. Srila Prabhupada was on television in America, and the man asked him, how would we recognize a Krishna conscious devotee? And so Prabhupada said, oh, he will be a perfect gentleman. So Prabhupada was pointing out that devotee's behavior would be pleasing to people. So that behavior is an important aspect of devotional service. Prabhupada writes, the particular word used by Srila Rupa Goswami in this connection is anushilana, or cultivation by following the predecessor acharyas.
Prabhupada 在这里提到，由释迦牟尼佛陀在这方面用到的特定的词汇叫 anushilana， 或者是说通过追随先前的 acharya 们去培养。
Following the footsteps of the acharyas, we are sometimes described as Prabhupada anugas.
Or Rupanugas,
means following in the footsteps of Rupa Goswami or Srila Prabhupada. And then Prabhupada talks about this Shilana. He said, as soon as we say cultivation, we must refer to activity. Without activity, consciousness alone cannot help us.
Prabhupada 接着谈到 shilana 这个词，一旦我们谈到培养，我们必须指的是活动。如果没有活动，知觉本身并不能够帮助我们。
So Prabhupada was very concerned like that. He would like to see everybody engaged in some kind of activity.
所以 Prabhupada 很关心这一点，他希望看到每一个人都有一个活动可以做。
One time in the temple, Prabhupada said to the temple president, he said, what is this lady doing? What service is she doing? And the temple president said, oh, Srila Prabhupada, it takes her all day to chant 16 rounds. But Srila Prabhupada said, no, cannot do like that. Everyone must do some activity. They must be engaged in some service.
Srila Prabhupada 说，不能那样，每个人都必须要做活动，每个人都必须要做一些服务。
Prabhupada wanted us all to be active in some kind of service.
Prabhupada 希望我们都活跃的去做一些活动。
Sometimes he would write to the temple president and say, everyone should go for sankirtan. and every temple would be empty, everyone just go out on sankirtan the whole day. So this was how we began the Krishna consciousness movement.
这就是我们如何开始的 Krishna 知觉运动。
Prabhupada wanted all to know what are we doing.
Prabhupada 想知道我们都在干什么。
How many books have we distributed?
我们派发了多少本书。
How many devotees have we made?
我们造就了多少位奉献者。
Prabhupada wanted to see the results of our activity.
Prabhupada 想看到我们活动的结果。
And Prabhupada, when he came, when he would come to visit us, he wanted activities. We had to arrange programs for him.
当 Prabhupada 来访问我们的时候，他希望有活动，我们要为他安排节目。
He didn't just want to, oh, I would just sit here and chant Hare Krishna.
他不是说就想着，哦，我就坐在这儿唱诵 Hare Krishna.
He wanted to go out for preaching.
他想出去做传播。
Or to bring people to him for him to preach to.
或者是我们可以带人来。
And he wanted us to bring important people to him as well.
而且他还想让我们给他带重要的人物来。
And in this way, Srila Prabhupada was engaging and showing us how we should engage in Krishna consciousness.
这样，Prabhupada就让我们去做，而且他是在向我们展示我们应该如何的从事 Krishna 知觉的活动。
So I think it's getting late. 现在 well, how's the time for me?
Should we do now? Should I have a break or something?
The
clock is 9:45 to 11:30.
Huh?
9:45 to 11:30.
What time is it now?
Now it's 11:05.
11:05.
You can
stop, you
know.
Huh?
You can continue some more. Okay. 我们再继续讲一些，还有25分钟。
All right, here, more about this word Anushilanam. So, Prabhupada's, this is taken from A Back to Godhead, which was published in 1960. The word Anu suggests that one should engage himself in the service of the Lord.Without any interval.
Anu 这个词指的是一个人应该没有间歇的让自己从事于对主的服务。
Right, I mean constant. You have to be always engaged.
这就意味着持续不断的，应该一直从事。
Right, you go out for sankirtan, you come back from sankirtan, and you worship the deity.
你出去做 sankirtan, 你做完了 sankirtan 回来，然后你就可以崇拜神像。
And then you have kirtan.Then you have class.
然后上课。
This way, always engage some activity.
这样呢，就一直从事于某种活动。
Prabhupada continue. He must be engaged in the service, 100% and always.
Prabhupada 接着说，他必须是从事于这个服务，是百分之百的，并且是一直的。
There must. So.Then the word Krishna means Krishna and his different expansions.
然后 Krishna 这个词指的是 Krishna 和他的各种不同的扩展。
And also we mentioned Krishna's paraphernalia.
而且我们还要提及 Krishna 的随身用品。
Like the mridanga drums.
比如说 mridanga 鼓。
Prabhupada, if he saw the mridanga drum on the floor, he would chastise the devotees.
如果 Prabhupada 看到 mridanga 鼓就被随意放在地上，他会责怪奉献者。
If you just place it on the floor, it would be that Prabhupada would tell us that you cannot do like this.
如果你把 mridanga 鼓放在地上 ，Prabhupada 就告诉你，你不能这样做。
You must keep the mridanga drum off the ground.
不能把 mridanga 鼓直接放在地上。
And similarly, also kartals.
同样道理，还有 kartal 挠钹。
And books, the different things which we use for Krishna's worship, we don't put them on the floor.
还有像书籍以及我们用来崇拜 Krishna 的不同的物品，我们不能把它们随意放在地上。
Even Lakshmi, money, we don't put it on the floor.
Lakshmi,
because we use Lakshmi for the service of Krishna. We have to take care of it. We don't put these things on the ground. And then Krishna's devotees, pure devotees, but they're also representative of Krishna. So we're careful in how we deal with Krishna's pure devotees. Careful with their photographs and so on. To respect all of these things. And then anushilanam, meaning constant and also activity. And it means we should be following the predecessor acharyas. So activities have to be there, and we get the inspiration for activities by hearing about the activities of the other acharyas. We enjoy to hear about the acharyas in our Krishna consciousness line. Hearing about their life is also not different from hearing about Lord Krishna and his pastimes. So it's important for us to always be engaged in these different activities. At the same time, following the acharyas doesn't mean to imitate the acharyas. Some people try to imitate Srila Prabhupada. Somebody may think, oh, Prabhupada went to America on a boat, I will go on the boat. Prabhupada went with no money, I will also go with no money. So of course you can imitate Prabhupada. But you're not going to get any results. So we have to follow the acharya, follow their example, but not imitate them. We want to understand what is the proper method of following the acharyas. So Srila Prabhupada and the acharyas, they have given instructions for us. Rupa Goswami and the other Sanatana Goswami, they have written instructions for us. Just like Rupa Goswami, he wrote also the Upadesh Amrita, the nectar of instruction. Nectar of devotion is a bit more lengthy. More verses, a lot more slokas, more complex. But the Upadesha Amrita, the nectar of instruction, there's only 11 verses there. But he takes us from the very beginning of devotional service to the highest level. So, and in the course of those verses, he gives these acharyas. Alright, so we've spoken about the Swarupa Lakshana, the essential characteristics. Now we're going to hear about the marginal characteristics. Tathasta. Maybe before we'll go on, we'll ask if there's any questions.
也许在我们继续之前，我们问问大家有没有问题。
Anyone has any questions about what we just prepared?
How does one continue always in service? Like one of the definitions is one has to do service continuously all the time. So maybe could you explain a bit more on that?
Pranam Pradyam Prabhu, 他就问 Guru Maharaj, 怎么去理解是去不断的去做服务？
It's not Pranam Pradyam.
Sudarshan,
I'm sorry. Okay, so constant. Yeah, we should understand how to apply this principle of being constantly engaged in Krishna's service. So, we
should understand this principle of being constantly engaged in Krishna's service.
Well, we have to understand that.Constant activity means also taking care of different duties which we have.
那我们要明白的一点，这种不断从事的活动也包括去照顾到我们的职责，履行我们的职责。
Srila Prabhupada says a devotee is not neglectful of his ordinary duties.
释迦牟尼佛则说，一个奉献者也不应该去忽视他的普通的职责。
But they're also part of his devotional service.
这也是他的奉献。
Just like you have a job, you have a family, you have to take care of these things.
就像你要上班，你有家人，你要照顾这一切。
And so working for Krishna, devotees work in the office or may work in a factory, whatever their work they're doing, but they're doing it for Krishna.
奉献者在办公室上班，或者是说在工厂上班都没有关系，他们在为 Krishna 而做。
And in one purport in the Bhagavad Gita.Prabhupada describes how devotees may be working in the factory or in the office, but they're giving the fruit of their work for Krishna. So he said these people are actually in the renounced order of life.
在巴格吉特国家梵歌的一个要旨之中，释迦帕帕都说没有关系，一个人他可能在办公室上班或者是在工厂上班，但是他们把他们的结果供奉给了 Krishna.
So they're actually in the renounced order of life.
所以他们实际上处在弃绝的阶层。
Because they're not attached to what they're doing.
因为他们并不依附他们所做的事情。
They're doing it for Krishna.
他们是为 Krishna 而做。
Just like Prabhupada told the devotees, you know, in the beginning when they come to Krishna consciousness, devotees.Prabhupada said, I think you all have to get a job. We need some money to maintain our society. But then when the devotees got jobs, some of them got jobs in a cigarette factory. So Prabhupada said, no, no, you cannot do that.He said, I'm devotees, cannot work in the cigarette factory. So there's some criterion there, what we can do and what we cannot do. But constantly we have to be thinking of Krishna. And if we have a job, we have to think of it as service to Krishna.And your family, taking care of your family, is also a service to Krishna. You see your family members as being connected to Krishna. So in this way, constant engagement is certainly possible.And constant engagement doesn't mean that you cannot sleep at night. We take rest so that the body can be healthy for the service of Krishna. Lord Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, don't sleep too much or sleep too little.
主 Krishna 在 Bhagavad Gita 之中谈到，不要睡得太多，也不要睡得太少。
So Srila Prabhupada told the devotees how much they should be sleeping.
Srila Prabhupada 告诉奉献者们，他们应该睡多少。
How much?He told some people need a little more. Okay, some people can manage on a little less.
他告诉有的人呢，他们可以多睡一些，有的人他们少一些也没有关系。
Just like eating, some people need to eat more, and some people eat less.
就像是吃东西一样，有的人需要吃多一点，有的人需要吃少一点。
So we have to maintain the body. Doesn't mean don't eat, don't sleep.
我们要维系这个躯体，不意味着我们说不吃了也不睡了。
But we sleep so that we can do more service for Krishna.
我们睡觉是为了为 Krishna 做更多的服务。
And we eat, of course, we only eat Krishna prasada.
我们吃东西，我们只吃 Krishna prasada.
And we eat enough to keep the body fit and healthy for Krishna's service.
我们吃足够的东西，去让我们的躯体很健康，可以好好的为 Krishna 做服务。
And so devotional service is very practical.
所以奉献服务是非常实际的。
Constant engagement in the service of Krishna.
不断地从事一个 Krishna 的服务。
Eating, sleeping, sometimes mating and defending is also there. Producing a Krishna conscious family is service to Krishna.
吃睡，有的时候还需要做交配和防卫。那么为了去扩展 Krishna 的家庭，我们还需要有的时候去从事交配的活动。
And then also, recreation.
还有娱乐。
Sometimes you need some recreation just to help us to, have more control over our mind.
有的时候我们需要适当的娱乐，是为了更好的控制自己的心意。
Prabhupada liked to go for a walk in the morning.
Prabhupada 喜欢清晨的时候去散步。
Then you go for a walk. You go to the different parks and walk.
那么散步的时候就去不同的公园去散步。
And so it's not Maya to go out for a walk.
出去散步并不是 Maya.
This morning they were telling us better to chant in here. You go outside.
今天早晨就有人拿那个大喇叭跟大家说，最好在这儿念诵，不要出去什么的。
But if we go together with devotees and in the company of other devotees, you're protected.
但是如果我们跟奉献者们一起出去的话，在奉献者的陪伴之下，我们就受到了保护。
Just like in Vrindavan, Prabhupada told devotees, don't go off on your own and go and wander around the different places in Vrindavan.
就像在 Vrindavan, Prabhupada 就跟奉献者们说，你们不要自己出去，在 Vrindavan 到处的溜达。
But if you go with devotees, as a group of devotees, you can go and visit different places.
但是应该是跟一群奉献者们一起出去访问不同的地方。
So like that, we have to, we need some recreation, we need some activities.It's not that we're totally restricted from all of these things.
我们需要一些娱乐，需要一些活动，不是说完全禁止做这些。
Of course, we don't go and play golf on the golf course, you know.
当然了，我们不会去高尔夫球场去打高尔夫。
But you can go swimming if you like.
但如果你们喜欢的话，可以去游泳。
Lord Chaitanya used to swim in the Ganga.
朱柴坦涅以前常常在恒河里游泳。
So.Your swimming is a Vedic sport.
游泳是一种伟大的运动。
And we hear, we were telling this morning about Krishna wrestling.
在这里，今天早上我们谈到 Krishna 的摔跤。
So wrestling is also Vedic sport.
摔跤也是一种伟大运动。
But be careful.
但要小心。
So some things are.Some activities are there. We need to be engaged in Krishna's service. We need activities.
所以说是有活动的，我们需要为 Krishna 的服务从事一些活动。
Sometimes going to work. Sometimes you have to go shopping. You have to go and purchase things for service to Krishna.
有的时候我们去上班，有的时候我们要去购物，我们要为了服务 Krishna 而去买东西。
But.We should do everything in Krishna consciousness. In Krishna consciousness, we're carrying the message of Krishna wherever we go.
而处在克什那知觉之中，就意味着无论我们去什么地方，我们都要承载着克什那的信息。
Mahaprabhu was with us in Penang.
Mahatma Prabhu 在槟城的时候跟我们在一起。
And he was, he made a one point. He was talking. He said he was trying to understand why Srila Jatapataka Maharaj was so successful in spreading Krishna consciousness.
他讲到一点，他就说他想到为什么圣陀迦帕塔克斯瓦米马哈拉什在传播克什那知觉方面取得了巨大的成功。
And he had the observation. He saw that wherever Maharaj goes, whatever situation he's in, he's always trying to give Krishna consciousness.
他说他观察到了一点，无论马哈拉什去什么地方，无论马哈拉什处在什么样的环境之下。
Right. Wherever he's in the hospital, or in the ward, in the clinic, whatever, he's always thinking, he's trying to give Bhagavad Gita and trying to give some Krishna consciousness to people.
无论他在什么样的地方，有的时候他在医院里，有的时候他在打仗的地方，有时候他在一个诊所，他都想把 Bhagavad Gita 给派发出去，把 Krishna 知觉给别人。
So that is a very wonderful quality of the pure devotee.
这就是纯粹奉献者的一个非常奇妙的品质。
Constantly thinking how to give Krishna.
不断地想着怎么把 Krishna 给别人。
And everywhere you go, it's got people chanting Hare Krishna.
无论他去什么地方，都会让人唱诵 Hare Krishna.
So this is constant engagement.
所以这个就是持续不断的从事。
Okay. Any other question?
还有其他的问题吗？
Yes.
Sometimes you do service for Krishna, but I think he's not pleasing me. But I do it just to please Krishna, just like sometimes we're doing things to please another person. But it's not pleasing myself. Can we do it like this?
No.
不能。就想的是，有的时候我们做一件事情是为了取悦别人，但自己也不喜欢，然后就挺不情不愿的。然后呢，我们就是不是可以这种心态去为 Krishna 做服务？就是想着这 Krishna 可能喜欢，可我自己呢就心不甘情不愿的，倒还做。答案是不。
Then that's not pure devotional service.
那样就不是纯粹的奉献服务了。
Because the attitude must be that you want to please Krishna.
因为态度必须是说你想要取悦 Krishna。
But if you're only doing it because somebody tells you to do it,
但如果你做只是因为有别人告诉你去做
and you're doing it reluctantly, not very willingly,
然后你勉勉强强的去做，不是自觉自愿的去做
then the attitude is not so pleasing.
那这个态度其实并不是特别取悦主
So we have to understand everything. What is important for us to please Krishna?
我们必须要明白一点，那就是取悦 Krishna， 这个是非常重要的。
The attitude, there must be that loving feeling for Krishna.
那这种态度必须是要对 Krishna 有这种爱的情感。
That if it pleases Krishna, we should be happy to do it.
如果是取悦 Krishna 的话，我们应该是很高兴的去欣然的去做。
And we should recognize our own failure, that we're not taking pleasure in the activity.
我们要认识到自己的缺陷，我们自己并不从中取得自己的快乐。
You understand?
明白吗？
Hare Krishna. Okay. Any other question? Yes.
还有其他问题？
Okay.
Those things I do not service.Because of aging, and then I have been bored with my leg. I really stopped service in the temple, and then I now I'm practicing at home. Is it
妈在去问他说，之前我在庙里做很多服务，现在我年纪大了，我就没有在庙里做服务，我就自己在家里边修行，可以吗？
But because her leg was not good, right?
他的腿不好。
Yeah, so, Maureen, yeah. Yeah, sometimes these situations are there, difficult. What to do?
有的时候有这种困难，那怎么办？
So, of course, sometimes if you approach the temple authorities and explain to them that you're having difficulty because of your health, they may be able to help you.
你可以去找庙里的权威，然后跟他们说你现在有一些困难，然后呢，你跟他解释完了，他们可能会帮助你。
Maybe the problem, is it a problem because to go to the temple is difficult for you with the bad leg?
对，问题是说因为你的腿不好，所以你就去不了庙了吗？
I have a surgery done.
Yeah, but?
I have a surgery done on my knee.
Oh.
Now having, it's an artificial
knee.
So it's very inconvenient for me to do more to service, and then I have to be careful on my step.
Yeah. Maybe they could come to the temple, come to you and bring you to the temple.
The problem is that my son is already moved out from my place, and then it's quite difficult to go to temple most of the time.
No, but temple can come and bring you.
It's too far. Because from KL to Klang is too far.
Oh.
然后，姑姑还是问他怎么样了，他就说是因为他做了一个膝盖的手术，他换了一个人工的膝盖，走动就很不方便，而且他的儿子搬出去了，不跟他一起住，没有办法送他去庙。姑姑还是就说，那也许庙里可以派人来接你到庙里去做服务。他说那个对他们来讲也很不方便，太远了。
嗯，他就在 Klang。
他住在 Klang，
另外一个城市，
说很远，在另外一个城市。
So, Yes, well, then you have to do service at home. Maybe you can do some service online.
是的，那你可以在家里做服务，也许你可以做一些在线的服务。
You know, a lot of devotees are they get in doing some work, just like people are often working at home nowadays. They don't go to office, they work at home.
就像现在很多人在家办公，他们不用去办公室上班。
So maybe you can also do your devotional service at home.We had one devotee in Vrindavan. There was this one devotee in Vrindavan. His name was Vibhu Chaitanya. So he became a devotee when we opened the temple there in Vrindavan, 1972, 73. And he took up the service, he was cooking for the deities. And he used to cook all the offerings. Every day. He was cooking every day in the kitchen. And he did it for many, many years. But then the old age,it became difficult for him to stand so much. So they gave him another service. And he was giving Charanamrita. People in Vrindavan come to the temple, see the deity, and they would come and he would give Charanamrita, he would put a drop of Charanamrita in their hand.
人们在文达文来看神像，然后他就给大家每个人派发一滴 Charanamrita 在手心里。
And after putting the Charanamrita, then he will wash the hand with some water.
然后喝完了 Charanamrita 之后，用一些水来洗手。
And then he would dry their hand also.
然后他还给人家擦手。
And so this way he was doing service.
他就这样做服务。
And he would do this every day.
他每一天都做。
He did this until he could until he left the body. So his samadhi is there in Vrindavan. He found some service that he could do. Right, so you're not able to go to temple, you have to find some way you can do some service. So maybe you can do some work online, get a group of people and read Prabhupada's books together and discuss with them. There are many people in your situation that cannot go to temple. But they can read the books at home. So you can organize some people to be with you every day online and just read the book. And tell them about Krishna. That will be very nice. You have to find some other way to do service to Krishna. I'm sure there's a lot of other things you could do for Krishna. And if you're staying in Klang, so there's so many people there. There's many people. You can invite them to your home even. And have a program with them. And you can have children come and have a children's class. Find some way to do some service for Krishna. Try to keep yourself active. So you have to be thinking how to do it, what to do. Even you cannot walk, you take a chair and you can just sit somewhere. If there's any temple near to your home, you can go to the temple, sit there and just show people Prabhupada's books. You can be outside the temple. You have to think, what can you do to serve Krishna? Service to Krishna is the life of the devotee. So you have to think how I can do service, what can I do? Krishna will help you. Yes, Prabhu?
Guru Maharaj, Mataji is quite popular in Singapore. She has been doing a few nice cooking videos. I think that's amazing service.
I'm not Singapore.
No, 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 but you used to do, I think you would do some video recordings of. She was teaching how to cook prasadam.
Oh. 烹饪的那个视频，教大家怎么做菩萨的。Wonderful，太棒了。
Yeah, please continue more doing that.
更多的做这个。Yeah,
put on different short videos showing people how to cook some things.
可以做更多的短视频，给大家展示怎么做好吃的东西。Very
viral in Singapore.
他在这个新加坡很火的。
Okay. All right, very good. Okay, I think we can stop here today.
Hare
Krishna.
Hare Krishna.